of every sort and a beast of fuel to be devoured. Thou shalt fall upon the open field, for I have spoken it, saith the Lord God, and I will send a fire of Magog, and among them that dwell pitilessly in the isles, and they shall know that I am the Lord, so will I make my holy name known in the midst of the people of Israel. Will not let them pollute my holy name any more, and the heathen shall know that I am the Lord, the Holy One in Israel. Behold, it come and is done, saith the Lord God. This is the day whereof I have spoken, and that they dwell in the cities of Israel shall go forth, and shall set on the fire and burn the weapons, both the shields and the bucklers, and the bows and arrows, and the hand sleeves, and the spears, and they shall burn them with fire 7 years, so that they shall take no wood out of the field, neither cut down any of the forest. For they shall burn the weapons of fire, and they shall spoil those that spoil them, and rob those that rob them, saith the Lord God. And it shall come to pass in that day that I will give unto Gog a place there of graves in Israel, the valley of the passengers on the east side. It shall stuff the noses of the passengers, and they shall bury Gog and all his multitude, and they shall call it the valley of Harmon Gog. And 7 months shall the house of Israel be burying of them, that they may cleanse the land. Yea, all the people of the land shall bury them, and it shall be to them a renown the day that I shall be glorified, saith the Lord God. And they shall live forever out of men of continual employment, passing through the land to bury with the passengers those that remain upon the face of the earth, to cleanse it. After the end of the 7 months shall they search, and passengers that pass through the land, when any man seeth a man's bones, they shall set up a sign by it, till the burials have buried it with the valley of Harmon Gog, and also the name of the city shall be Hamanana, and thus they shall cleanse the land. And the Son of Man, thus saith the Lord God, speak unto every feathered fowl, and to every beast of the field, assemble yourselves and come, gather yourselves on every side to my sacrifice, that I do sacrifice for you, even a great sacrifice upon the mountains of Israel, that you may eat flesh and drink blood. You shall eat the flesh of the mighty, and drink the blood of the princes of the earth, of rams, and of goats, and of bullocks, all of them fatlings of Bashan. And you shall eat fat till ye be full, drink blood until ye be drunken, of my sacrifice which I have sacrificed for you. Thus saith, you shall be filled at the table with my horses and chariots and mighty men, and with all men of war, saith the Lord God. And I will set my glory among the heathen, and all the heathen shall see my judgment that I have executed, and my hand that I have laid upon them. So the house of all Israel shall know that I am the Lord their God, and from that day forward from the heathen shall know that the house of Israel went into captivity for their iniquity, because they trespassed against me. Therefore hide I my face from them, and gave them into the hand of the enemies. So fell they all the sword according to their uncleanness, according to their transgressions have I done unto them, and hid my face from them. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, now will I bring again the captivity of Jacob, and my mercy upon the whole house of Israel, and will be jealous for my holy name. After that they borne their shame, and all their trespasses, for thereby they have trespassed against me, when they dwelt safely in their land, and none made them afraid. When I have brought them again from the people, and gathered them out of the enemies' lands, I am sanctified, earned them in the sight of many nations. Then shall they know that I am the Lord, their God, which caused them to lead in the captivity among the heathen, and I have gathered them unto their own land, and have left none of them any more there. Neither will I hide my face any more from them, for I have poured out my spirit upon the house of Israel, say the Lord God. Chapter 40. In the 25th year of our captivity, in the beginning of the year, in the 10th day of the month, in the 14th year after that city was smitten, in the self same day, the hand of the Lord was upon me and brought me hither. My visions of God brought unto me into the land of Israel, and set me upon a very high mountain, which was the frame of the city of the south.